Hello students, in the last class or in the previous lectures we have discussed about the hybridization concept, right? Okay, so in that hybridization, what is the hybridization we discuss, and later that we discussed about the features of the hybridizations, and again later that the conditions required for the hybridizations, okay, and later that we have also seen how many types of hybridizations are possible, how many types of hybridizations are possible. Okay, so that is generally when the s and p orbitals involved, when the s and p orbitals involved, how many types of hybridizations are possible with the s and p orbitals, atomic orbital, it possible sp, sp2, sp3. Okay, so three types of hybridizations are possible. Okay, when the s p and d orbitals involved, that we can see later. Okay, that is either sp2d or sp3d2 or some d2 sp3, like this some are there, but now we are not going to worry about this. Just when the in the hybridization, when the s and p orbitals involved, you can see the three types of hybridization. One is the sp hybridization, another one is the sp2, and third one is the sp3 hybridization. Okay, and these are also we have discussed in the last class. So that is in the sp hybridization, right? So in the sp hybridization we discuss one s orbital and one p orbitals involved in the hybridization and form the equal number of atomic or equal number of hybrid orbitals. Okay, and later that they can rearrange and gives the linear geometry, linear geometry. Okay, and very similar to that, when you go to the sp2 hybridization, you see here in the sp2 hybridization one s orbital and two p atomic orbitals involves in the hybridization and gives the three sp2 hybrid orbitals, and then they can undergoes to the rearrangement and give the trigonal planar geometry, right? Okay, similarly come to the sp3 hybridization, one s orbital, three p orbitals involved in the hybridization and gives the four number of sp3 hybrid orbitals, and later they can rearrange and give the tetrahedral geometry. Okay, so these things we have discussed in the last lecture only. Now we can go to the today's topic, that is the examples. Those are the examples for the sp, sp2 and sp3 hybridizations. Okay, so first let us see about the sp hybridization, examples for the sp hybridization, right? And the one best example is the beryllium dichloride, beryllium dichloride. Okay, so in the beryllium dichloride, okay, so what you have to do is that just I'll explain while writing just with this example. Okay, so you see that the first beryllium dichloride, okay, so in the beryllium dichloride, what is the central atom? The central atom is the beryllium. Okay, and in the beryllium, what is the first, what is the basic criteria? Is the electronic configuration, right? Electronic configuration. What is the electronic configuration? That is 1s2, 2s, 2s2. Okay, 1s2, 2s2, right? Okay, so that is only thing, right? 1s2 and 2s2, right? And this is a, you consider it as a ground state electronic configuration. Okay, and next one is the excited state. Okay, next one is the excited state electronic configuration, that you can write two electrons here and two electrons here. Okay, and you know that in the outer shell, if it is a 2, there will be a 2p also there, but it has a 0 electrons. Okay, in the valence shell, second orbit, right? In the second orbit, along with the s orbital, p orbitals will also be present, but that is empty, that is empty. Okay, so in the excitation, what will happen? One of the electron from the 2s will excite into the 2p. Okay, so that now it is a type of 1s2, 2s1 and 2p1. Okay, so again in the hybridization, now in the excited state, what will involve? Generally the half filled orbitals. Okay, that is one s orbital and one p orbitals involved in the hybridization. Okay, that is 2s orbital and 2p orbitals involved in the hybridization, and gives the already you know the two number of hybrid orbitals. So what hybrid orbitals? One s involving, one p involving. So that these are the two sp hybrid orbitals. Sp hybrid orbitals. Okay. So just we can see in the pictorial that one s orbital involve, one s orbital with the one electron, right? Here is the one electron is there, na? One electron plus one p orbital with the one electron. One p orbital with the one electron. Okay. And these involve in the hybridization. Hybridization, and gives the two number of hybrid orbital. What is the shape of the hybrid orbital? One big lobe and one is the small lobe, and it contains the plus and minus. And the two hybrid orbitals again contains the one one electron. Okay. So what hybrid orbital? One s and one p. So that it is a sp hybrid orbital. Okay, sp hybrid orbital. And later that they can rearrange. They can rearrange and gives the geometry of linear. Okay. So you have a two hybrid orbital. So one is here, one is this with the one electron, and another one again it takes the linear position. Linear position because to minimize the repulsions between the electrons. Minimize the repulsions between electron. You know that according to the VSEPR theory. According to the VSEPR theory. Okay. So what is the shape? This shape is the linear, and center is the beryllium. You know that beryllium, and it is a positive and positive. Okay, linear geometry, right? Okay. So now this rearranged beryllium hybrid orbital, this involved in with the overlapping with the chlorine atoms. Chlorine atoms. Okay. So what are there here? Beryllium is a combined with the chlorine, right? Okay. So in the chlorine, again I am writing chlorine. In the chlorine, with the what atomic orbitals it will overlap? Generally in the chlorine, the electronic configuration is whatever that inner state I am not writing, that is with the 3s2, that is 3s2 3p5. Okay. So that means one of the 3s2 is filled and one of the p orbital is empty. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, this orbital is empty, right? Okay, this orbital is empty, right? Okay. So that means these orbitals involve the overlapping with the beryllium, right? Right? Okay. So first you write the beryllium. That beryllium has a geometry of the linear with the hybrid orbitals, okay, with the 1-1 electrons, with the 1-1 electrons, okay, and it combines with the two chlorines. Chlorines, what orbital? P orbital. Okay, so that is P orbital of chlorine. P orbital of chlorine. Okay, and generally it contains with the opposite spin. Opposite spin. Okay, and when they are combined, it gives the, what will happen? One orbital overlap here and another orbital overlap here. Okay, so how I am writing here? So these are the hybrid orbitals of the beryllium, and the chlorine atomic orbital overlap like this. One chlorine overlap here and one more chlorine overlap here. One more chlorine overlap here. Okay, so these are the two electrons here. Two electrons involved in the bonding. Okay, so what kind of bonding it is going? Along the internuclear axis. So that this bond is a sigma bond and this bond is also a sigma bond. Okay, so center one is a beryllium and this is a chlorine, and again this is a chlorine. Okay, so that means you can write the geometry as beryllium dichloride. Beryllium dichloride. Okay, so what is the bond angle now? The bond angle is 180 degrees. Okay, so again the geometry, that is linear. The geometry is linear. Okay, so like this you have to write the hybridizations of the beryllium dichloride. Okay, and how many sigma bonds are there? It has a two sigma bonds, two sigma bonds, okay, two sigma bonds, right, two sigma bonds, okay. Yeah, same thing you can look at here in your notes, that is in the ground state, the beryllium ground state, and in the excited state, and these two involves in the hybridization and gives the two sp hybrid orbitals, and they can rearrange and give a geometry of the linear shape, okay. And later that this beryllium involve overlapping with the chlorine atom, okay. In that chlorine again, what orbital involved? That is a p orbital, okay. So that p orbital of the chlorine overlap with the beryllium, right? And that beryllium structure, now it is a beryllium dichloride, beryllium dichloride, okay. So here, what is the bond angle here? The bond angle is 180 degrees, and the geometry is a linear, and how many sigma bonds are there? Sigma bonds are two sigma bonds, okay, sigma bonds are two, right, okay. Very similar to that, next we can go to the sp2 hybridization example, okay, sp2 hybridization example, okay. So in the sp2 hybridization, the best example is the boron trichloride, boron trichloride, okay. So in that, what is the central atom? Again, is the boron is the central atom, and what is the ground state here? The electronic configuration, generally the atomic number is 5, ground state electronic configuration is 1s2 2s2 2p1, 1s2 2s2 2p1, let us consider it as a z, okay. And this is the electronic configuration. In the excited state, what will happen? One of the s orbital electron will excite into the p orbital, okay. So that means it gives the 2s1 2p x1 or 2p z1, you consider it as a 2p x1 2p z1, or you can consider it as a 2p y1 or 2p z1, okay. And whatever it is, but again, these s orbital and 2p orbitals involves in the hybridization, okay. So that means one s orbital and 2p orbital. Again, here I am writing, if you want to confuse, just one s orbital plus 2p orbitals with the 1 1 electron, okay. So one s orbital and 2p orbitals involved in the hybridization, and gives the three number of hybrid orbitals with the 1 1 electron, and later that this can rearrange and gives the trigonal planar structure, okay. And in this, each contains the one one electron, okay. And later that this trigonal planar structure overlap with the chlorine, okay. So that means in this is the boron, this is the boron, and it overlap with the three chlorines, right? In the boron trichloride, how many chlorines? Three chlorines are there, right, okay. So that means it has a three chlorines, so these are the three chlorines, and they can overlap like this. So three chlorines, and how they can overlap? The borine overlap with the chlorine. How they can overlap? They can overlap, the each chlorine overlap with the one hybrid orbital. Here it is the overlap with the hybrid orbital, and this chlorine also overlap with the hybrid orbital, okay. So finally, it is a geometry of the trigonal planar, and you can write the geometry, the structure you can also write like this, boron trichloride, okay. So now, what is the bond angle here? The bond angle is, generally it is a trigonal planar, the bond angle, you know that it is a 120 degrees, okay. And how many sigma bonds are there? How many bonds? So you have a three sigma bonds, okay. So because one is along this, one is along here, one is along here, okay. So three sigma bonds are there, right, okay. And the next one is the sp3 hybridization, sp3 hybridization. And the best example, you know that it is a methane. And in the methane, what is the central atom? Carbon is the central atom. The electronic configuration, the atomic number is 6, and the electronic configuration is 1s2 2s2 2p2, 1s2 2s2 2p2. Okay, so that means how it should be. So that is 1s2 and 2s2 and 2p2, right? Okay, one electron here, one electron here. Okay, and in the excitation, what will happen? One of the s orbital electron will excite into the p orbital. Okay, so that you can see here, that is in the excited state, 1s2 2s1 2p3. So that means one of the electron shift to here, so that is a one electron will be here and one electron be here. Okay, so that means after that, these one s orbital and three p orbitals involves in the hybridization. Okay, so how it is, that is three p orbitals and one s orbital. Okay, so for your convenience, you can also write like this: one s orbital with the one electron plus three p orbitals. Okay, so these are the p orbitals involves in the hybridization. Okay, and gives the how many number total? 1 plus 3, so that you can give the 4 number of hybrid orbitals, 4 number of hybrid orbital with the one one electron. Okay, and later that it can rearrange and gives the geometry of the tetrahedral. Okay, so after this formation, tetrahedral geometry, it can combine with the methane. What is that? Hydrogens. Okay, so it can combine with the hydrogens, overlap with the hydrogens. Okay, so generally in the hydrogen, what is the electronic configuration? It is only 1s1, so that it contains the s orbital. These are the hydrogens, 4 hydrogens, and this is the carbon, and these hydrogens overlap one with the 1 1 orbital, hybrid orbital. Okay, so this is the final geometry. So you can also write like this: the carbon contains the hydrogen, one bond here, one bond here, and another bond here, and the one more bond will be here. Okay, this is the structure. Okay, and how many what is the bond angle here? The bond angle is 109.5 degrees. Okay, and how many bonds are there? You have a 4 bonds, and the 4 bonds are again sigma bonds. 4 bonds are sigma bonds only, right? Okay, so this is an best example for the sp3 hybridization, right? Okay, and now we can see the one more example for the sp3 hybridization, that is the ammonia. That is ammonia, you know that ammonia shows the sp3 hybridization. Okay, so how we can say that the ammonia is that? Generally in the central atom is a nitrogen, and atomic number is a 7, and the electronic configuration 1s2 2s2 2p3. Okay, so in this 2p3, this is a, you assume it is a ground state. Okay, right? And in this, is there any possibility of the excitation? Is there any possibility of the excitation from here to somewhere? No, right? Because already these p orbitals are half filled. Okay, so that there is no excitation of electrons. Okay, so that as such, this s orbital, 2s orbital involved in the hybridization as such. Okay, so that means one s orbitals and three p orbitals involved in the hybridization and gives the sp3, 4 number of sp3 hybrid orbitals. Okay, and here one point I want to say from the silent futures, just previously I told you that some of the few points I'll explain later. Okay, so what are those is, yes, so these are the important conditions we learned in the hybridization concept in the previous lecture, and that is in the important conditions for the hybridization. Okay, so what is that important condition? One of the point, that is the third point, promotion of electron is not an essential condition prior to the hybridization. Okay, so that means every time the promotion of electron is not an essential one. Okay, సో యూ నో నీడ్ టు థింక్ దట్ ఓకే ప్రతిసారి ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఎగ్జైట్ అయితేనే అది హైబ్రిడైజేషన్లో ఇన్వాల్వ్ అవుతుంది అని అలాంటిది ఏమీ లేదు అనమాట. ఓకే ద బెస్ట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఈజ్ అమోనియా. యూ సీ హియర్, హియర్ ఈజ్ దేర్ ఎనీ ప్రమోషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్? ఏమైనా ప్రమోషన్ అయిందా ఇక్కడ ఎలక్ట్రాన్? నో రైట్. సో యాజ్ సచ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్వాల్వింగ్. ఓకే సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద పాయింట్ ఐ వాంట్ టు సే ఇన్ ద హైబ్రిడైజేషన్. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ మోర్ పాయింట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో దేర్, దట్ ఈస్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ నాట్ నెసెసరీ దట్ ఓన్లీ హాఫ్ ఫిల్డ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ పార్టిసిపేట్ ఇన్ హైబ్రిడైజేషన్. ఇన్ సమ్ కేసెస్ ఈవెన్ ఫిల్డ్ ఆర్ వేకెంట్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ ఆఫ్ వ్యాలెన్స్ షెల్ మే టేక్ పార్ట్ ఇన్ ద హైబ్రిడైజేషన్. ఓకే సో దట్ మీన్స్ యూ నో నీడ్ టు థింక్ ఎవ్రీ టైమ్ హాఫ్ ఫిల్డ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఇన్ ద హైబ్రిడైజేషన్. ఓకే సో ప్రతిసారి హాఫ్ ఫిల్డే ఇన్వాల్వ్ అవుతుందని మనం ఆలోచించాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు. ఇన్ సమ్ కేసెస్ ఫిల్డ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ అవుతాయి, ఈవెన్ వేకెంట్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ ఆల్సో ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఇన్ ద హైబ్రిడైజేషన్. ఓకే సో ద బెస్ట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఈజ్ అమోనియా. యు సీ హియర్ దిస్ ఈజ్ అ కంప్లీట్లీ ఫిల్డ్ రైట్. ఓకే టూ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఇన్ ద 2s. సో దట్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫిల్డ్ వన్, స్టిల్ ఇట్ విల్ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఇన్ ద హైబ్రిడైజేషన్. ఓకే సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద టూ పాయింట్స్ ఆల్రెడీ ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ దట్ ఐ విల్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ లేటర్. ఓకే దీస్ ఆర్ ద టూ పాయింట్స్ నౌ. ఓకే సో ఆర్ యూ క్లియర్ నౌ? ఎస్ రైట్. సో వన్ ఎస్ ఆర్బిటాల్ అండ్ త్రీ పి ఆర్బిటాల్స్ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఇన్ ద హైబ్రిడైజేషన్ అండ్ గివ్స్ ద ఎస్పి త్రీ హైబ్రిడైజేషన్ ఫర్ ద అమోనియా. ఓకే సో ఇన్ ద అమోనియా ఆల్రెడీ ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ దట్ ఇన్ ద అమోనియా నైట్రోజన్ అటామిక్ నెంబర్ ద జెడ్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 7 అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ 1s2 2s2 2p3. సో దట్ టూ ద ఎస్ ఆర్బిటాల్ అండ్ త్రీ పి ఆర్బిటాల్స్ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఇన్ ద హైబ్రిడైజేషన్ అండ్ గివ్స్ దట్ ఈస్ అ ఎస్పి త్రీ హైబ్రిడైజేషన్. ఓకే సో దట్ మీన్స్ హౌ మెనీ? ఇట్ గివ్స్ ద 4 నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎస్పి త్రీ హైబ్రిడ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్. ఓకే అండ్ యూ నో దట్ లేటర్ దట్ దే కెన్ రీఅరేంజ్ అండ్ గివ్స్ ద దే కెన్ రీఅరేంజ్ అండ్ గివ్ ద టెట్రాహైడ్రల్ జామెట్రీ. ఓకే బట్ లుక్ ఎట్ హియర్, హియర్ ఇన్ దిస్ 4 హైబ్రిడ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ యు సీ హియర్ 3 హైబ్రిడ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ 3 హైబ్రిడ్ ఆర్బిటాల్ ఐఎమ్ రైటింగ్ 3 హైబ్రిడ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ 3 హైబ్రిడ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ విత్ ద 1 ఎలక్ట్రాన్. ఓకే బికాస్ హియర్ ఇట్ 3 అటామిక్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ కంటెన్స్ ఓన్లీ 1 ఎలక్ట్రాన్. సో దట్ హియర్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో 3 ఎస్పి 3 హైబ్రిడ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ కంటెన్స్ ఓన్లీ 1 ఎలక్ట్రాన్ అండ్ ద రిమైనింగ్ 1 హైబ్రిడ్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ కంటెన్స్ 2 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ 2 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్. ఓకే సో దట్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఎస్ ఆర్బిటాల్. యూ సీ హియర్ ఇన్ ద ఎస్ ఆర్బిటాల్ 2 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ పెయిర్డ్ 1. సో దట్ ఇన్ దిస్ 1 ఆఫ్ ద ఎస్పి 3 హైబ్రిడ్ ఆర్బిటాల్ కంటైన్ ద 2 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ బట్ రిమైనింగ్ 3 కంటైన్స్ ద 1 ఎలక్ట్రాన్. ఓకే అండ్ లేటర్ దట్ దీస్ కెన్ రీఅరేంజ్ అండ్ గివ్స్ ద జామెట్రీ ఆఫ్ టెట్రాహైడ్రల్. ఓకే సో ఇన్ దట్ 1 this is the one hybrid orbital and this is the second one and it is a third one and you assume it is a fourth one. Okay so the picture may not be that much of good and in that one hybrid orbital contains the 2 electrons and remaining 3 contains 1 electron okay and this is the nitrogen after rearrangement. Okay and this again will ఓవర్లాప్ విత్ ద ఆర్ రియాక్ట్ ఓవర్లాప్ విత్ ద హైడ్రోజన్స్. ఓకే హౌ మెనీ హైడ్రోజన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్? 3 హైడ్రోజన్స్. సో హైడ్రోజన్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ ఈస్ ద 1s1 సో దట్ ఇట్ కంటైన్స్ ద ఎస్ ఆర్బిటాల్ విత్ ద 1 ఎలక్ట్రాన్. ఓకే సో దీస్ 3 వన్ కెన్ ఓవర్లాప్ హియర్ అండ్ వన్ కెన్ ఓవర్లాప్ హియర్ అండ్ వన్ కెన్ ఓవర్లాప్ హియర్. ఓకే సో ద రిమైనింగ్ ద లోన్ పేర్ దీస్ పేర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ రిమైన్ యాజ్ ఎ lone pair of electrons. Okay so that you can see here very well. So this is the geometry of ammonia. Okay so in that this is the central is the nitrogen and the one hydrogen overlap with the hybrid orbital and another one. Okay and the above one is the lone pair. Okay so finally what is the geometry? This is the lone pair and these three are the bond pairs. Okay you can write like this: the nitrogen with the lone pair and hydrogen and hydrogen. Okay, so what is the geometry? The geometry is a pyramidal geometry. Pyramidal geometry. Okay, and what is the bond angle now? Generally, in the tetrahedral structure, the bond angle is 109.5, but in the ammonia, it is less because of the bond pair, lone pair repulsions. You learned in the VSEPR theory, right? Okay, so that is the reason why the bond angle is, it is less than 109.5, so that is around 107 degrees. Okay, not okay. So the ammonia structure, it is a pyramidal and the bond angle is a 107 degrees. And generally, how many bonds are there? You have a three bonds, that is all are three sigma bonds. All are three sigma bonds. Okay. And one more example, that is for the sp3 hybridization is a water, H2O. Okay. H2O. So in that, the central atom is the oxygen. And what is the electronic configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Okay, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. And again, here is also, is there any possibility of the excitation? No, right? So, as such, they can involve in the hybridization. In that, 1s orbital and 3p orbitals involve in the sp3 hybridization. And it gives the 4 number of sp3 hybrid orbital. 4 number of sp3 hybrid orbitals. Okay, and again in this 4, 2 with the pair of electrons and 2 with the unpaired of electrons. 2 with the paired electron, 2 with the unpaired, because the 2 orbitals with the pair of electrons and remaining 2 are with the unpaired of electron. Okay, so these are the paired and these are the unpaired. Okay, so again later that these oxygen combined with the hydrogen. Okay, so how many hydrogen? 2 hydrogens are there. So this is a hydrogen and contains a 1-1 electron, and these two will overlap with the hybrid orbitals with the unpaired of electron. Okay, so that means it gives a geometry of like this, oxygen combined with the hydrogen and hydrogen, and this is the geometry, right? What is the geometry? This is a V shape or angular shape. V shape or angular shape. Okay, and again the bond angle is less than the 109.5, that is around 104.5 degrees. Okay, so this is due to the lone pair repulsions are greater than the lone pair bond pair, and even the bond pair repulsions. You know that as per the VSEPR theory. Okay, so these are the geometries successfully explained by the hybridization concept. Hybridization concept. Okay, so now we can see the few more examples of the sp2 and sp3 hybridization. Okay, so you know that the very well examples, ethane and ethane, right? Ethane and ethane. Okay, so I'll come from the ethane, that is ethane C2H6 and ethene C2H4 and ethane C2H2. Okay, so in this, the ethane is a very good example for the sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization. Okay, so that is how they explain the ethane structure. Is that very simple? In the ethane structure, the central atom is a carbon, the central atom is carbon, and the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, and there is a possibility of the one excitation from s to the, this is the 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, right? Okay, so there is a possibility of the excitation from 1s to the p. Okay, so in the excitation, that is the s 2s1 and 2p3, 2s1 and 2p3, and these 4 involved in the hybridization and gives the sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization for one carbon. Okay, and you know that how many it gives? It gives the 4 number of sp3 hybrid orbitals. Okay, and those sp3 hybrid orbitals rearrange and gives the geometry of tetrahedral. Okay, these, that means in one carbon there is a geometry of tetrahedral. Okay, this is the one carbon and this is the one more carbon. Okay, because we have a two carbons here, right? Okay, So every carbon has a same kind of electronic configuration and excitation and involving in the hybridization. Okay, so this is the one hybridization, this is the another carbon, another carbon. This is a one carbon, this is another carbon. And along with that, is there any? You have a six hydrogen, six hydrogens. Okay, so these are the six hydrogens. You know that every hydrogen contains the s orbital with the one electron. Okay, and that involve, so one hydrogen in the six hydrogens, one hydrogen overlap here and another one here and another one here. So fourth one, fifth one and sixth one. Okay, and meanwhile what will happen? The one of the carbons sp3 hybrid orbital overlap with the another carbons sp3 hybrid orbital and form a sigma bond. Okay, and here it is a hydrogen, 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 hydrogen and hydrogen. Okay, so overall how many sigma bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 sigma bonds, 7 sigma bonds. Okay, so what is the shape on the each carbon? On carbon is tetrahedral and the hybridization is a sp3 and the bond angle is 109.5 and total how many bonds? Total you have a 7 sigma bonds. Okay, 7 sigma bonds. Okay, this is the geometry of the ethane. Next, come to the ethene. Come to the ethene. And ethene is C2H4. C2H4. And central, again the central is the carbon. And electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. And is there any excitation? Obviously, the excitation is possible. So, one of the electron from the s will excite into the p. So, that means 1s2, 2s1, 2p3. 1s1, 2s1, 2p3. Okay. So, but in this, not all the 3 p orbitals, only 2 p orbitals involve in the hybridization. Okay. And gives the sp2 hybridization. Okay. So, sp2 hybridization, you know that. What is the geometry of the sp2 hybridization? That is a planar structure. Planar structure. Okay. So, that I am going to explain here. So, sp2 hybridization, right, on the each carbon, okay. So, what is the geometry? Planar geometry. This is a planar geometry, okay. But on the carbon, you see here, how many orbital? That is a 1, 2s1 and 2p3. 2s1, 2p3. Here 1 s orbital and 2 p orbitals involved in the hybridization, right? And what about this? This is not involving in the hybridization. Okay, so that you can call it as a unhybridized atomic orbital, right? Okay, and these three involve in the hybridization and gives the three number of sp2 hybrid orbitals, three number of hybrid orbitals, and you know that these can rearrange and gives the trigonal planar geometry, okay. That is the thing here I have mentioned. Okay, and everyone with the one electron, okay. So this is with the one electron. Okay, so now come to the next thing. What about these? This is also there, right? Unhybridized orbital. Okay. And that should also be there. Okay. Then where it is that the unhybrid orbital will be there in the perpendicular manner. Because you assume either it is a px or py. So then it will be in the perpendicular. Okay. So now you can see that the red orbital, px orbital, that is perpendicular, okay. This is on one carbon. Similarly, the same thing will be possible on the another carbon also. You see that this is another carbon and these are the three hybrid orbital, blue one, and the red one is the unhybrid orbital, and along with that it combined with the four hydrogens with the one electrons. Okay, right. And finally, they can combine and give the geometry. First, these sp2 hybrid orbital overlap and gives the sigma bond formation. And later that, the hydrogens overlap with the sp2 hybrid orbital 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so at last, the p orbitals also they write with the 1-1 electron p orbital, and these two also can overlap perpendicularly. Okay, you know that any orbital overlap perpendicular to the internuclear axis, that gives the pi bond formation. Okay, so that means in this one is a sigma bond and another one is a pi bond. Okay, so that is the shape of this. On each carbon it is a trigonal planar, and the hybridization is a sp2 and the bond angle is 120 degrees. Okay, similarly we can see the another example for the sp hybridization. The example is ethyne and c2h2 and a carbon. What is the geometry? 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2. Okay, so in that the excited state, is there any possibility? Right. Okay, so one electron excited from here to the p, so that is 1s2, 2s1, 2p3. You assume 2pz1, 2py1, 2px1. Okay, so in this, one of the s orbital and one of the p orbitals involved in the hybridization, and you know that when the two orbitals involved in the hybridization, it gives that two number of sp hybrid orbitals, and they can give a geometry of the linear. These can give the linear geometry, right? Okay, one hybrid orbital like this and another hybrid orbital like this, okay, with the 1-1 electrons. Okay, but whatever the remaining two, these two also there, right? So these two takes the, here I am showing, so these two again remain like that only, that is perpendicular. One is the px and another one is the py. Okay, so this is the geometry on one carbon. Similarly, the same geometry is possible on the another carbon, that is on the other carbon, and along with the carbon, how many? The remaining two hydrogens also there, and they can overlap together and give, initially these hybrid orbital overlap together and form a sigma bond, single sigma bond, and later that two hydrogens overlap, one is here and one is here. Okay, so that means these are the two carbon hydrogen bonds, and the remaining unhybrid orbitals are there, right, with the 1-1 electron, okay. So these overlap perpendicularly to the internuclear axis, and that resulting bond, you know that it is a pi bond. How many are there? Number here, px is overlapping with the px and py is overlapping with the py, so that two possibilities, two overlappings are there, so that it gives the two pi bonds. Okay, so one sigma bond and two pi bonds. Okay, and what is the shape? The shape is again linear. Hybridization is a sp hybridization and angle is 180 degrees. Okay, so these are the examples for the sp, sp2 and sp3 hybridizations. Okay, so are you clear about this? Right, in the next lecture we can see the hybridizations involving the d atomic orbitals. Okay, right.